simply pick up the Lolita first time for Beloisky.
And it's so good because
it
it's
is.
Too
it really
him.
Is, exactly.
Oh, wow.
This is a hero that has been left under the, you know, in this draft so far based on the two games. You haven't seen it at all. Actually, no. Based on the 9 games they played in the upper brackets, they haven't played this at all. This is insane. Finally, bringing in up the Lolita.
Yep.
And look, they're going up against two marksmen. Like you said, it's really good timing. With Blacklist, they're forced to now. Only Lilia is opened up for that mid laner if they do want to put this Nathan in the jungle.
But then again, there's a lot of choices, right? Rafaela, as well as the Barats. I mean, Rafaela provides for the Barats to become a jungler. So it is indeed going to be the case. Edward going to be put in that Esmeralda slot again. Esmeralda versus Uranus.
Haji Beatrix.
Haji Beatrix, exactly. And look at him go. Coach Yeb making sure that his team is ready to go. It's gonna be a mountain to climb. It's only just 2 more wins for Blacklist International. But for Onyx PH, they have to start with 0.
Well, let's see right now. The coaches will show each other respect right there. And man, based on the draft, I feel like both have a very good draft. It's all gonna come down to the execution. But one thing I'm scared of is Onyx PH, they usually just really like to play on with those winning lanes. Now, with this draft, you can kind of say that their winning lane, I don't know about it.
I think that my guess is Farsa is going into the gold lane.
Farsa is going, yeah.
Yeah, confirmed Farsa is gold lane, and then we're going to see that trademark Cho in mid for Hatred. Yep. And, you know, as for Blacklist, we already confirmed it, Haji on the Beatrix. Let's see how this performs in game number 3 in this best of 7 for the World Championship. Onyx PH versus Blacklist International. I'm loving it.
Well, who would have thought that we'll go back in 2021 for a double tank setup in the mid lane? And the support roles, right?
Wait a minute.
It has been a long time.
Haji blasting away at Beloisky, forcing out that flicker. Oh my Venus puts in a little more just to make sure. Forcing out an early recall down bottom, but here in this lane. Close. He's going to get denied his gold. Kart barely gets it. Marky with the wings by wings, scaring him to death. Almost to death.
Oh, look at the Barats. I think he's going to make a move on to Farsa.
Hello. That's a 2v1 down there. Kairi using that passive so perfectly. They're going to get first blood on the Marky.
No way.
A surprising amount of damage on the Barats. Kairi tries this away too much. It's a double kill for the big Dino on Wise.
God. Ultimate bonding experience. That is the name of the game. What the heck was that? I'm lost for words right now. Wise.
That's a massive lead, man. Wise was just phenomenal. Using the so-called teamwork as well as the big guy passive. And Onyx PH made a mistake trying to go close range against the Barats. That's what you never want to do. Surely you have the passive from Yisun Shin, but both Farsa as well as this Yisun Shin so low makes it so that just one kill for Wise will proc the killing spree and eventually will win the 2v1.
Not to mention the holy healing. So yeah, perfectly put. It's a mini ultimate bonding experience, but it was so clutch. 1,000 gold ahead already. Blacks International starting up this turtle. They're gonna pull it over to their end of this nest. Mountain Shocker checking where everyone is. Edward gonna try to keep Dilarski at bay. Here's all 4 members wailing away. Oh, maximum range on this turret. And that's going to be Detna's welcome. Getting mobility, throwing him into a wall. Kairi going to secure it. Bombs away. Haji throws out.
Edward?
No caution to the wind. That's Kairi taken down. Traded out for Edward. 2-for-1 so far. Beloisky falls. Blacklist International securing the body count but gives up the turtle. Was that worth it?
Definitely not for Onyx PH, for sure. They get the turtle, surely. But then again, Blacklist International again with the baits. They lure Onyx PH into that spot once again where they were clumped out together. And with the AoE from Blacklist International, it's just way too good of a damage. And the fact that they also had to use Marky into the mid lane.
Into that Numenon blast and Dilarski punishing them, putting so many stacks on that Ionic Edge. Spots out the Queen. He's not done. He's going to try to take down this Rafaela. Holy healing. Detna's welcome. Dilarski purifies and let's go. Wolf, you were saying?
Yeah. They had to use the Farsa into the mid lane, which kind of left Oheb free with at least 2 lanes.
Oh! finally gets it. So there's a little bit of delayed gratification for Onyx.
Look at that face, Marky, with the smirk right there. He's so happy about that. But again, Blacklist International now early on already pushing in the pace. This is not going to be good. Wait a minute.
That's going to be a fight here in the purple buff. A punish onto the attempted steal and invade. Wow, again, it's a holy healing and the killing spree. Deadly combo.
So fixated into trying to punish Wise this time, and so far Wise has been winning all of them. 3-0 and 1 on this Barrett's with the help of Oh My Venus, just not leaving this. This is again Rafaela and Barrett's combination, and on Blacklist International are really the big proponents of this, and they have mastered it so well.
Well, let's see right now. Blacklist International going in with the winning lanes, able to get so much done on the map. Again, this is one of the critical elements that made Onyx PH such a force in that upper bracket. The winning lanes that are able to set up for the turtle for that neutral objectives, the banana split, remember. And now Blacklist with their own winning lanes and their winning jungler. It's so hard for Onyx Philippines to just crack open and just play their game. The banana split hasn't been a thing since game 2.
Yep, in a vacuum, yes, Onyx is winning the lanes 1v1. Dilarski dictating the pace, I mean, kicking Edward out of his lane. But when it comes to these engages, these exchanges, I mean, Blacklist International just winning completely, securing that turtle, forcing Bolojski away. And in this case, it's fine. Edward looking low. Dilarski gets a kill. Haji unable to protect his Esmeralda. They're going to have to disengage here. And look how deep Onyx is.
Yeah, again, Onyx Philippines, this is what they need to do. They need to start to play their own game, play their game. Oh, no.
Bolojski taking down the shield was not enough to protect him. Plus the tenacity. Haji on this Beatrix, something else.
This was far too low. I think it's again, Wise just running literally over this Lolita. Destroyed. And Lolita cannot stop the damage output coming up from Wise. And they're just using this Barrett's with the turtle buff so well. And look at how much chunk, how big of a chunk of a damage he deals against all of these heroes. That's the strength of a jungle Barrett's, and with the Rafaela to help him out with more movement speed. And then eventually the War Axe proccing, it just makes so much place for the team. And eventually, we just talked about it, do two sentences. And eventually Blacklist gets a push up the bottom lane.
You're right, Marky has to be present. If not, they'll just suffer the same consequences. Wise trampling over them with this Barat, so they have to perfectly time these team fights. I'm guessing Kairi has to be on point every time.
Yeah, finally now, it's actually a switch, right? Usually we see Onyx PH, the ones with the early lead. Oh my goodness, picking up another kill on the board, and they're looking for more here. Onyx Philippines on the other map, on the other side, I mean.
That's it. Haji goes for the Rage, and there's a wave of the Dragon.
Damage.
But they just served him up to Kairi. Edward pushing them back. Bolojski with the Numenon Blast. Trapped between three members. They're going to try to get this kill. And there's the Rage. There's the Passion. And there's a trade so far. One for two. Haji goes down. Cheered out for Edward. And they're just pushing in. So many turrets going down. Top, bottom, mid. Only going to be stopped by Marky. Wings by wings away. Here comes Oh My Venus and Edward biting down. Marky's going to survive this one. Mountain Shocker. Oh My Venus catches a few. But Wise is going to steal away this orange.
Oh my goodness. Total map control for the side of Blacklist International as Ohev is now freely farming around. When Blacklist International makes a play on the opposite side of the map, there is Ohev just taking turrets. And now they are farmed a 4,000 gold lead for Blacklist International.
Two levels right now for Wise on top of Kairi. Oh, Hatred!
Okay.
Way of the Dragon by Hatred on top. Catches the Space Time Walker. Oh, Moving on Blast, no one home. That's going to be the turtle. Prioritized here by Yi Sing Shin. Onyx PH gets it, but at what cost? His life! Edward takes down Kairi. Bolojski and Dilarski are running. Here comes Edward dancing around Bolojski. Put up a shield. I'm gonna eat it. Dilarski as well. There's a holy healing stunning the Uranus. Look at the damage coming in from Marky. Blasting away at the Esmeralda. He's dancing away, prancing to safety. And Wise looking to punish. He's gonna stomp down onto this Uranus. And here comes Edward and Haji answering back. Renner from Haji. And there's a jump falling star moon from behind the turret. Hatred looking for a target. Knocks up Wise. Answers Dutton's welcome and the way of the Dragon.
Wow.
He still eats him up though. Num, 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 num. Down the Barat. Venus goes as well. What a re-engage and a counter initiation by Onyx, resulting in a 2-for-none.
What the heck is happening now? Both of the teams going turn after turn again. Both of the sides just baiting it out. And now we are going to take a look at a replay here, Wolf.
Yeah, I think this is where we are going to see where that double stun came from. Again, I have to give it to Hatred, that catching Wise off and then delaying this Way of the Dragon for a little bit so that they can catch up. Eventually, there's the stun. It came from both Baloyski as well as Marky. And then eventually, they just took two heroes, cutting down the deficit to just 800 and getting the mid lane turret as well. Bottom lane push, Onyx Page have recovered. And it was off of them just trying to win the fights, the extended fights now. Blacklist International lost.
Marky was the MVP in that fight, man. You see the positioning of that man going over the wall from the orange buff, actually. Not getting caught in the choke point that Blacklist International set up with that Nibiru's Passion. But now, Blacklist 4,000 gold lead already down to a 700. This is where Onyx PH can look for some fights, can look for that banana split.
Yep, they closed the gap. And after two games, they finally figured out this fluid type of team play, this counter engage frontliner light strategy, but actually they have to invest in Alita and Uranus to get it. But again, third time's a charm. They might turn this around. 9 minutes, 30 seconds in. Blacklist retains their gold lead, keeping it at about 1,000, keeping that gap open. What's next here? Who do they target? I'm talking about Blacklist International because it looks like it's going to be Baloyski. Detna is welcome into that Lolita. Is this a fight that Wise wants to take? Numenon Blast onto the big dino. Kairi takes him down.
Very nice pick off for the side of Onyx PH, and this is exactly where they find...
Oh, Hunty! Yeah! Flame shot from down south, taking down that Beatrix.
Oh my god, Marky! The snipe from downtown as they're gonna look for the Lord. But yes, what I wanted to mention is this is where they're most comfortable, right? Onyx PH with the lead and going banana split. Larsky on the Uranus just being such a nuisance, distracting every single member. And look, objectives coming in their way. This is the Onyx PH I expected to see in game one.
Hatred finds one with the Feathered Airstrike response by Marky, zoning away Blacklist International. And now, with that one win, I mean, they did get a Lord here. They're backed on the lead. Onyx PH about 2K.
You know how they found the kill onto Wise? Wise was quite deep, yeah, for sure. But Onyx PH normally will not take the fight because that's a bad anyways. Hatred actually spotted out both Ohev as well as Oh My Venus. And he actually wasn't found by both Ohev and Oh My Venus. That little opening, that little information that Onyx PH was able to get and read onto Blacklist International allowed them to make a play against this Wise Barrett. And then eventually the fight.
And that's exactly how Onyx should be playing, right? Answering heroes on a multiple level scale. Trade up. In that sense, it was Hatred who won. And now it's the Uranus on Dilarski down bottom. You have to really check him out.
Marky.
What was that?
The damage from Marky. That's just Marky.
No, not just the damage. He's playing like a Forza. He's playing like a brawler,
exactly.
A fighter. He's going in 1v5.
He flew. He used his mobility tool.
Check down bottom, Haji's in trouble. Oh, uses that Purify to protect himself. They're gonna go ahead and take down a turret in mid. Now gonna be the inhibitor in mid as well. So that's tier 2. And all tier 3s, they're all inside the base now. Baloyski catches quite a bit. Might have been too much. Flicker already used up. Holy healing by Oh My Venus. Denton is welcome. Dilarski purifying. No, actually just staying alive. It's a cancelled engage by Blacklist International. And it's enough. Marky is just so ahead here. Even sitting at 315, he's playing like he's 6-0-3.
Gonna have to give it to Baloyski though. He's very brave against Blacklist International. He's already at 4 deaths. Has to be very careful actually. But I think he knows his limits. Does have the Athena shield now on top of the grass.
Finds one Way of the Dragon. The perfect assassination. Execution at its excellent. And that's going to be one traded out though. I mean, worth it if you're going to be taken down. The Marksman, but look at this jump by Edward.
Marky?
Falling Star Moon onto Marky, shutting down the Farsa 2 for 2. It's getting messy, but it's what they need to close the gap.
Yeah, Onyx Philippines, this is exactly what they need. Make it messy, because inside of Blacklist International, they want to make it just very organized, with the ultimate bonding experience. And honestly, that is why is that so surprising to us? Because we've seen more tank chos, more like semi-tank chos in this tournament. Finally seeing someone with high and dry and that much damage able to just one-shot Ohib, that's something that's so unnatural to us, to our eyes right now.
And I would really have to give it to Hatred. He probably have played it so much. He knows exactly how much damage he's able to get. Yeah. I mean, nobody would have jumped against three members of Blacklist International to think that there is a Rafaela to really sustain that guy. But Hatred knows that with his high and dry, he's going to be able to get kills. Baloyski is far from home as well as Hatred. But
There you go, spotted out. He knows exactly where everyone
is.
No, no, no. On to three. Here comes Hayden from the back. Taken down. Oh, I'm serving you up to Kyrie. And now Wise caught out in the middle of three. Another way of the dragon onto the big dino. Mark Yazzer's back with a feathered airstrike. Down
Red
goes Wise.
Trade slain.
One for two so far. Marky getting
Blue
danced on. Taken down by Haji. And now Edward going to be protected. But yes, top lane is getting pushed in. Edward's still onto Beloyski here. And this is exactly where Beloyski wants him.
Wait a minute.
And they let go.
Oh, that's the split. Hatred, though.
Hatred. Oh.
It's going to be checked by one way Venus.
Spotted. Spotted.
Look at the just one attack with only fast. Just clear, almost clears the card.
It's not over.
They're not done. Dilarski slowing down Haji. There's the Nibiru's passion. Oh. Haji looking the way of the dragon. Oh, the stacks as well. Down he goes. Beloyski, Hatred still alive. Edward looking for him. Numenon Blast unable to keep Omae Venus down.
Oh. No way, he
and
gets
Hatred outplaying him with the flicker. And there's the Falling Star Moon. Enough for Edward to take him down. So messy. So many teamfights happening at the same time. Dilarski chasing him down. And I think we're going to slow down here. Pace yourselves, boys.
Nope, we're not.
We're not.
Nope, it's just Dilarski buying time. And there's the answer by Marky. Feathered air strike plus the flame shot into the dark.
Wise.
Entropy switching it up. And okay, they disperse.
Oh, disperse, finally. But then again, I think this is an opening for Blacklist International to actually take the Lord. They know that the feathered air strike is not yet available. So that is really the call here, but it will be spotted out. Oheb as well as Weiss, they deal so much damage onto the Lord, and Omae Venus as Edward were just zoning them out. Great call from Blacklist International.
Red team has
My god, the way they chain these events together is just so unnatural. So well done by Blacklist International. But now it's time to take a look, deep dive at the items. Now we finally know why Hatred's doing that much. The Blade of Heptices and the BOD. This is a full damage show. But that last item, he was building a little bit defensively now. Beloyski finishing up that dominance ice as well. At this point, we're talking about the late game. Who has it?
I can easily say it's Blacklist International. They have two
marksmen. Wait.
No, they're trapped. What a pincer maneuver from Blacklist.
Oh, they're going to get Marky here and Dilarski. Beloyski still has a chance to retreat, putting up that shield.
Oh.
They let go and top lane. You got to watch top lane.
Marky.
This is very fast. Marky gets taken down. Slain. Too late. Charging up the Numenon Blast. Oheb. Forward entropy, in this case backward, trying to chase down Dilarski, and Edward goes to answer the show up top.
Somebody has to stop this bottom lane push.
No one's going to. No one can to.
Wait
a minute. Beloyski, he's not going for the Lord. He's going for a fight.
Yeah, because Kairi made the call, and Haji answers back with a Nibiru's passion. Ooh. But the damage is done. The damage is done. They get bottom lane inhibitor.
Oh, what a sneak coming out from Blacklist International. A great read, knowing that Onyx Page cannot engage anymore. And we're talking about scaling, right? Mirko, you asked this question. I would say it's easy for Blacklist International to take it. Then again, if you're looking at their itemization, it also amplifies that fact because now they have a healer shield that costs Oheb and Weiss, which means that they now have the ways to deal with a Marky. And so far, as good as Marky was in the first few minutes of the game, this time at 16 minutes, it's more difficult. Surely his contribution to teamfights is still very good. The wave clear is still there. The damage, the burst is there. But then again, it's already being answered by Blacklist International.
Let's see. Right now, Blacklist International going in and zoning away the members from the side of Onyx. He should take the turrets down in the mid lane as well. Beloyski, he's there, but you know he's just tanking up damage. He's just trying to be a nuisance, but the damage is just simply too much from the side of Blacklist. Look at how they're able to control the map here. They take two waves for the price of one in that bottom side. Let it be.
Yep, prime positioning for Marky though. Despite the rocky and turbulent past couple of team fights, he still knows his job. And right now, he put his foot on the clutch, changed gears, and it says that now they're playing a defensive game. Hatred, he's changed from being an assassin into a split pusher, and he's trying to find this free kill onto Edward.
No
way. 4v1, but here comes the rest of Blacklist. They're going to
go
ahead and collapse. Look at the switch up. It's Marky now caught in no man's land. Oheb gets him. And that's one down for the side of Onyx BH. Four defenders versus five. They're looking to siege. They're looking to get more inhibitors.
Oh, man. You got to have to be amazed how Blacklist International is just baiting Onyx BH so many times. Hatred wants to go for a play. Maybe onto Haji this time.
Oh, he's going to get it.
Is he going to get it? Is he actually looking to get it?
Hatred, where are you going?
Patience
he has
Hatred.
Free entry. There's a Numenon Blast.
Blue
they are going to take this inhibitor yet again.
Red
Edward goes down, maybe a little too forward. Hatred?
Oh.
No.
Patience
from Hatred.
Not here.
They feel like they don't have enough damage, and I honestly do understand. Marquee was taken down. Without Marquee, it's only Kyrie that can really go and deal damage. But if you look at the compositions, do you really want that Yi Sun Chen to dash forward? Exactly. It's not going to be an option whatsoever. So very, very good patient play coming in. Even though it might have looked like a good play, in the grander... it's just not going to look. It's not going to work, honestly.
Yeah. You have to be careful if you're Onyx.
Oh wait! Denton is welcome. Purified here, let go. Answer back by Marquee. Feathered air strike, down goes Oh My Venus, popping the immortality. Kyrie taken down by Wise. There's a three-man stun with the Numenon blast. The flame shot down south, buying Baloyski one kill. Could there be another? Backwards entropy, here comes Edward dancing around. Wise still trying to fight against his Uranus, still has an immortality. He's getting blasted
here by
Farsa. Here comes Haji. Oh, who is he spot? Oh, this is
Lord. This
back
is Lord.
Backline took too much. That's a 2-for-1, and eventually, yes, should convert into a Lord.
Yeah, it looked really good for Onyx PH, but you gotta remember that it was the jungler traded for Venus, all right? Venus is only a roamer in this game. He's only died 2 times. It's not going to be that huge factor that can turn around the game, especially in this 19-minute mark. Onyx PH, they might have bit too much than they could chew right now.
I agree. And now they're trying to split the map, but with more heroes in favor in Blacklist International, might be good. Marquee going for the steal, will not get it.
Not gonna happen. They tried it with the Ionic Edge as well. Here comes Hatred, catches a blast from Haji and Oheb as well. Nice jump in by Edward, not gonna find any contact. Just like that, Blacklist International scores a Lord and is back to doing damage control on the map. It's relatively blue, so at least Onyx has done good on that front.
4,000 gold lead for Blacklist, and they're going to be able to push in more here. Again, 2 inhibitor turrets taken away. That is 2 constantly pushing waves. They can build it up with the Lord as well. Look at the bottom side, slow pushing. Mid lane as well. Top side can just do that, and this might just be the end of the game. This is most probably going to be the final fight either way.
That's 20 minutes. You have to be careful if you're Marquee. You're the only wave clear, the guaranteed wave clear from Onyx PH, and
He's already used it.
That is true.
He's going to have maybe one more by the end. Dilarski, though, look at the burst on the side of Blacklist. Doesn't get caught by the Renner. Here comes Wise facing out Baloyski. And there's the damage from Oheb. Entropy already in tow. Dilarski putting up a perimeter. The only hope left for the PL. Marquee with a feathered airstrike. Gonna stave the Lord here this time around, but they will lose top lane inhibitor. It's not over. They're still going. Look at how low Dilarski is popping him with immortality. There's an open blast stun on the 3. There's an immortality
pop. The base.
It was all about the base. Blacklist International able to score 3-0. What's
Match
happening?
Point.
Oh my goodness, and the punish was there. Blacklist International, they started this game strong. They're the lineup with the better scaling, but with 2 kills onto Wise, it allowed them to just control the lanes. By God, Onyx PH actually were able to recover, making this game free very interesting, but unfortunately, just the raw damage and scaling from both the Nate and the Beatrix, it was just way too good from Blacklist International, and now they're at match point.
They did enough in that last team fight to move up the waves, to make sure that Marquee was overloaded when it comes to his responsibilities as the only good choice for wave clear, and eventually snuck in that win. Could have been close. Could have been one more defense, especially after that 3-man Numenon blast. It's gonna